Hello everybody, welcome to this channel. My name is Dick van Oeveren and I have received a very nice present today. I've received a Aruba 6100 switch in a box. And so I'm gonna install it, unbox it and configure it today. So hope you're gonna like this video. Let's get to it. Let me just unpack it and see what's in the box. And after unpacking, what I'll also do is I'll power it up, install it and configure it so that I have access to the switch and can start configuring. So this is the content, the inside of the box. There's a lot of stuff in there. Let me just show you what's in there. There's a leaflet with the installation and warranty information. Installation safety and regulatory information. Right, okay, so we officially need to read that. Some silica shell to keep the box dry. Power cord here. So this is a European power cord. We've got a bag with accessories. And I'll show you that one later on. And let me just get the switch out of the box. Box as well. Nice cardboard stuff here. And this is the switch. Okay, just more plastic. Okay, an unboxed switch. So you got the power inlet, 230 volt or 110 if you're in the US. So the serial number at the back and the MAC address. On the front side, we have, so this is a 24 port switch, PoE switch. So you got the 24 10/100/1 gig ports. And there are four uplink ports. These are 10 gig uplink ports, four of them. And then on the left side, or on the right side, depending the way you look, we have some connections. So you've got a USB-C connection here at the bottom. This is for your serial connection for configuring the switch. There is another USB connection here where you can connect some external storage, like a USB stick to store your configs and stuff like that. There's this little mode button. It's called, what's it called? LED mode button that changes the behavior of the LEDs. And there is this embedded reset button as well here at the bottom here. You need a paperclip and that will reset your switch to factory defaults. So as said, so this is a 24 port model. There's also a 48 port model, either with or without PoE, and there is also a 12 port model. It's a nice and shallow switch. It's not very deep, so it allows you to get this box installed in, like smaller closets. Okay, finally, the accessory bag. Okay, let me just unpack it. So we've got the rack mount kit, two pieces of course. There's a tie wrap. This is probably either for your power cord or for your data cables. For the rack mount kit, there's also some screws. So you got the black ones. The black ones are for mounting the mounting brackets onto the switch, and the silvery ones are for mounting onto the rack. And then finally, we've got these nice little rubbers, and they are, so if you are using the switch as a desktop model or tabletop, whatever, you can stick those to the bottom here. So there are, you can see some markings here, marking there, and then you can just stick those onto the bottom of the switch. Okay, so that's the switch. Next is to power on the switch and see if we can get it configured. Okay, let's get this thing started. Power on the switch first, get the power cord. Oh dear, yeah, got it. And hook up the power. There is some noise at the beginning. So these are the fans that you hear. So they will be running at full speed when the switch is started up. But after like, you know, here you go. After like 10 seconds, the fan speed goes down and it's a very nice and quiet switch. I will also connect a DAC cable to one of the 10 gig ports here. Say port 25, there you go. And I will get my laptop. There you go, my laptop here. And hook up that laptop as well to the console. You can see that the switch is still booting. Oops, out of console, out of USB here. So connect the USB here. And yeah, so it's extracting the image. And let's wait a while before the switch has been booted. Okay, switch is initialized and booted. There you go. Now, when you log in for the first time, let me just do that. There is no password on the switch. And so what you have to do is, with the initial login, you have to assign a password to the admin user. You don't have to, you can hit the enter button twice, so there will be no password for the admin user. But you know, it's better to configure a password, which I will do now. So I'll assign a password to the admin user. And now the admin user is configured. Now the next step is to check whether I have some connectivity. So I have the DAC cable connected to as an uplink to the network. Let me just check whether there is connectivity. So what I'll do is I'll do a show interface brief. And so what I can see here is that for interface 25, I have a DAC transceiver, but it says unsupported transceiver. So for some reason, the transceiver or the DAC cable is not recognized by the switch. What I can do is the 6100 or the AOS-CX switches in general support the unsupported transceiver, right? So what I can do is I can get into the terminal and allow unsupported transceivers. Unsupported transceiver, enter, say yes. And now, so now this transceiver should be recognized. So if I do a show interface 1/1/25. You should be able to see that 1/1/25 is up now. And if I do I'll just use the arrow up, show interface brief, you can now see that the interface is up. So that's good, we're good there. Now, next step is to configure an IP address because I want to be able to access the switch. Because the 6100 doesn't have an out-of-band management interface, so unlike the 62 and 63, well, and 6400, so the 61 is basically, it's a layer 2 switch. It's an entry-level switch, and this switch does not have an out-of-band management interface. So what that means is that you need to configure one of the VLANs to allow, you know, to get IP connectivity to the switch. So the default VLAN is VLAN 1, interface VLAN 1. So what I'll do is I'll configure an IP address on interface VLAN 1. VLAN 1. And let me just do IP address 192.168.0.100/24. Okay, so that will be the IP address. And I should now be able to ping something that's on this VLAN, right? So for example, the gateway. .1. Okay, good. Means that we have connectivity. That's good. Now the next thing to configure is obviously when we want to have remote access like SSH or HTTPS access, we need to enable the SSH server and we need to enable the HTTPS server. Let's start with the SSH server. So SSH server, exit first, SSH server, VRF. Now, the 6100, because it's a layer 2 switch, it doesn't have any understanding of VRFs. However, because of the way CX is operating, it requires a VRF to be assigned. So basically, the 6100 only has one single VRF, which is the default VRF. So I'll just enter default. And now we've got the SSH server configured and enabled for the default VRF. We have to do the same for the HTTPS server, VRF default. And another thing, if we want to configure REST, so if we want to have access to the REST interface of the switch, and if we want to have read-write access, so not just obtaining information, but also pushing information using the REST API. So what we need to do then is we need to configure the access mode and set it to read-write. Okay, so now we can read and we can write using the API. And then obviously, finally, writing the configuration would be write memory. And so this kind of like concludes the initial configuration. What we can do now is we can start to configure the switch using either SSH or the web interface. And let's just do that.
Let me start with SSH. Let's see if we can SSH into the box. Yes, we can. Let's provide the credentials. Let me just increase the font size a bit. So you can see that we're on the switch. So we can do show running config. You can see that there's an initial configuration with the IP address, HTTPS is configured, and we can start configuring the switch through SSH. Let's configure terminal. Put a question mark. You can check out all the options that you have. It's an advanced layer 2 switch, so there's no layer 3 configuration supported other than IP addresses on VLAN interfaces. Other than that, there's a wide range of functionality and features. You can configure access lists, policies, port security with .1x or MAC authentication, spanning tree, VLANs, link aggregations, So there's an extensive set of functions and features available on the 6100. Okay, let's move to the web interface. See if we can access the web interface. 0.100. It's HTTPS, so there's no certificate installed there, so we get this message. And there you go, into the web interface of the 6100. You get into the dashboard with all the, you know, that, which gives you like a high level overview of what's happening on the switch. You can get into the interfaces view, show some interface information. VLANs, you can actually configure VLANs here. You can configure link aggregations, set up users, monitor your PoE usage and everything. And there's also some system tools functionality available. Things like making backups and checkpoints of your configuration. You can do firmware upgrades from the web interface. And in addition, you may already know this from the other switches, there's also the Swagger interface that we have for the REST APIs. So, you know, you can obtain all that information using the Swagger interface. You get the firmware, you know, whatever API calls you can make here. So that's pretty cool. And this concludes the unboxing, installation and configuration of a 6100. I hope you liked the video and I hope to see you soon on this channel.